Hello students, welcome to Sushmita's classroom. I hope all of you are keeping well. Now, let us begin my class with this well-known thought given by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. The thought is, if you fail, never give up, because fail means first attempt in learning. How wonderful the thought is, how encouraging the thought is, how motivational the thought is. Now students, today's topic is models. Last week I told you about will and shall. Now in this video I will tell you about would and should. Okay? Just to revise you, will, shall, would, should, can, could, may, might, must, ought, need, dare, used to. These are all model verbs or model auxiliaries, or you can only say only models, okay? In which will and shall has been done. Now today we will do would and should. Now first thing is would. When would is used in negative form, we will write would not or wouldn't. This is the way we write in negative form. Now, when we use the uses of would, first one is to express past habit. When we show some past habit, when we express some past habits, at that time, past tense, we use would. Like, he would go for morning walk. That means in the past tense, earlier, he would go or he used to go for morning walk. Next one is to express polite request. When someone requests you politely, at that time, would you pass this plate? Would you pass this book? Would you give me your pen, please? So this type of sentences we use would to show polite request. Now, next thing is to express a wish or preference. Suppose I wish that it should be happened to me, or I prefer something. At that time, we use would at that. Like, I wish you would apply for this post. I wish. Secondly, I would rather take tea or coffee. This sentence is showing preference, and the first sentence is showing wish. I wish you would apply for this post. I would rather take tea or coffee. Preference, then that whether I would like to take tea or coffee. So here I am showing my preference. I would rather this, prefer to. I would prefer to take tea or coffee. In that time, I can say I would rather take tea or tea than coffee. Okay. Now, next one is to express an imaginary condition. Imaginary condition is that condition has not been done in the real life. Okay. But just imagining. Like, I would change the rule if I became the minister. If I became the minister, then only I would change the rule. Here I am showing an imaginary condition. In this sentence, I am showing my wish. In the second sentence, I am showing my preference. Here, in this sentence, to express polite request, would you pass this plate? That means I am requesting someone, but politely requesting. Means normal request se jada, politely requesting. Next one is to express past habit. That means something we used to do earlier. In that case, we can write would also. We would go for morning walk. I hope you understood. That means first time to express past habits. Second is to express polite request. Third is to express a wish or preference. And fourth one is to express an imaginary condition, which is not real, just imagining. At that time, we use would. Now, next is should. When should is written in negative form, it is said should not or shouldn't. This is the way to write it, negative. Okay. To express duty, obligation or desirability. Should is used to express duty or obligation, or either indesirability, means something desire. When we desire something, we can write should. For example, we should obey our elders. This is our duty that we should obey our elders. We should listen to our elders. We should respect our elders. Next is, you should not talk like this. That is desirability. I desire that. This is my wish. This is my desire that you should not talk like this. Okay? Next thing is to express possibility or probability. That means chances are high. This is the possibility. Or probability means again maybe there are chances. For example, he should reach his home by 9 p.m. Someone has gone from here and I can say that most probably he should reach home by 9 p.m. So that is you are saying possibility. Okay? Chances. Now next one is to express purpose after lest. When lest is used, after lest, should is used to show the purpose. In expression of fear, when someone is doubting about something or someone is feared for it, that time we write should. For example, work hard lest you should not be able to get through. So here lest means or otherwise you should not be able to get through. At that time, should is used to express the fear. One important thing is, should often implies a mild suggestion or advice. Like it is here, you can talk, it is, you can say here, it is suggestion also. Suggestion and advice at that time also should is used. It is a mild form of must. Like that, you should work hard for the exam. This is the mild form of must. You should work hard for the exam, which is showing a suggestion or an advice. I hope you understood. Now quickly revise this one. First one is to express a duty or obligation or desirability. Second is to express possibility or probability. Third thing is to express purpose after less to show the expression of fear. And next one is should is often it is used to show the to give the suggestion or to give some advice. I hope you understood this one. I hope you understood the difference between would and should and the uses of would and should. Now let us practice one exercise. Now let us do this exercise. Fill in the blanks with would and should. First one, he dash always tell lies. You have to fill whether would or should. He dash always tell lies. It is showing the past habit. So we will write would. He would always tell lies. Now second one is, whenever his father was angry, he dash walk out of his room. Whenever his father was angry, again it is showing something past habit. Whenever his father was angry, he would walk out of his room or he should walk out of his room. I think he would walk out of his room. It will be he would walk out of his room. Next one, the landlord shouted that the tenant would and should leave the house. The tenant dash leave the house. Again, it is showing desirable. Okay, so then that means it would be should. The sentence will be, the landlord shouted that the tenant should leave the house. Next one, he dash have told me if he was unable to do it. Again, something imaginary condition. He should have told me if he was unable to do it. Okay, so it will be he would have told me or he should have told me. He should have told me if he was unable to do it. And the last one, I wonder who dash be able to help me. I wonder who would. It would be who would. Now quickly, just revise it. He would always tell lies. Whenever his father was angry, he would walk out of the room. Nowadays, the landlord shouted that the tenant should leave the house. Next one, he should have told me if he was unable to do it. And the last one is, I wonder who would be able to help me. I hope you understood the difference between would and should and the uses of would and should. Now we have completed will, shall, would and should. In my next video, you will see about can and could, the uses of can and could. Thank you. I hope you like this video. Do write me if you have any doubt or if you have any query or you want to know more about all these things. Please write. Thank you.